Hi, billionaires. It's your billionaire boss chick, Tiffany Renee, and your host of Biblically Speaking, where we take trending topics and give you a biblical worldview. Listen, I am so thankful for you all watching our videos every week, and we want you to continue. So today, I'd just like for you to like the video, subscribe to our channel, and then hit the notification button. Why? Because you don't want to miss anything, and we upload new content every week. So hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and then hit the notification button. Pretty simple, right? Well, thank you, and watch this. All right. Good evening to everyone. Thank you for tuning in. It is your billionaire boss chick, Tiffany Renee, H-E-I-R, heir to the throne, joint heir with Christ, equipping you to live this kingdom life. And today is another episode of Biblically Speaking, where we take trending topics and give a biblical worldview. I'm super excited about tonight, so we're going to go ahead and go into prayer, and then we're going to go into what we have for you tonight. So Father God, we just thank you for anointing my lips with clay and allowing me to be able to speak and teach your word. We thank you for every ear that comes to hear this and that will come across this video even in the future. And what we pray is that it blesses them. Lord, we thank you for who we are in you. We thank you for all the blessings that you've bestowed upon us. We thank you for Jesus. We thank you for just loving us and being the ultimate Abba, the one and true God. We thank you. We love you. We bless you. We ask you to just allow this word to get down in our hearts and our spirits, and that we may not just be hearers of the word, but doers of the word. And that as we learn who we are today, that we will walk it out boldly, because you have called us to be kings and sons of yours. And so we just say thank you for that. We love you. We bless you and magnify you in Jesus' name. Amen. All right. So last week, we talked about soul hunters. I'm going to go back to that so we can just do a little bit of recap. And we talked about, soul hunters, and we talked about, you know, what that is and how people sometimes try to control you, manipulate you. We gave some examples of it with Lucifer, Nimrod, and Julius Caesar. And these people wanted to control. Lucifer was pretty much jealous of God. And he was like, you know what? I want to do that. I want to have that. I want people to worship me. And so we talked about soul hunters, how sometimes, you know, the enemy will hunt our souls. We know he comes to steal, kill, and destroy. And we have to be mindful of those things, that we're not connecting ourselves to people who are trying to control and manipulate us. And sometimes that can be family, and sometimes it can be close friends. And you just want to be, you want to recognize that spirit and understand what they are sent to do so that you can circumvent that. So today, we are going to talk about who you are in Christ, and knowing who you are in Christ and how important that is, because, you know, if you know who you are in Christ, then the enemy, he already is a defeated foe. But when you know who you are, you can use that to your advantage. So I want you to just listen to something here.
Who are you? I know exactly who I am. The question is, who are you?
I'm nobody. So Leave me alone, all right?
Everybody is somebody, even a nobody.
Yeah, I think you're confused.
I am confused? You don't even know who you are.
Oh, and I suppose you do.
Follow me. I will show you.
Here's how to find.
You see things as.
Start selling online.
All right, I just wanted you guys to hear that because in the introduction it says, "Who are you?" And the guy says, "I'm a nobody." And he says, "Nobody, everybody is a somebody." And he says, "Leave me alone. I think you're confused." No, you're confused because you don't even know who you are. And oftentimes the enemy will put things in our heads. Now, in this instance, that person was speaking there, was speaking in a positive light. But oftentimes the enemy will speak lies to us about who we are. And so it's important that we know who we are so that when he does speak those lies, we have something to fight with. We can combat it. So it says in the book, and remember, we're studying Cleansing Your Generational Bloodline, Restoring the First Estate by Natasha Gerber. In the book, she says, the biggest thing that you always are going to face is the enemy saying to you, who do you think you are? You cannot allow him to intimidate you and accuse you all the time. You have to learn to take what the enemy hits you with and turn the tables. Either you're going to let him hit you over the head every 5-10 minutes, or you're going to turn his accusations into a battle axe and hit him back. And this really reminded me of, Tuesday in our pivot experience, in our pivot life group, we talked about maturing and making maturity moves. And we talked about what does that look like when you actually mature? And it reminds me of me, you know, as I matured in Christ, when things happen, you know, I am not woe is me. I'm not all over the place and feeling like it's the end of the day because I already know the battle is already won and that everything has to work out for my good. So therefore, whatever this situation is, it has to be something that I'm in it that I'm going to gain from it. I'm going to learn from it. And so what do you say to who when the enemy says, who do you think you are? Or you can't do that. And he spits that venom. What do you say? Who are you? So let's look at who does God say you are? You know, you really do have to know who you are so that you can speak like, you know, speak in authority. And that's why we're going to go over who you are so that when the enemy speaks those things, you'll have something to fight with. One, it's not about you. You have to get excited about the honor of God, not your honor. And this is Natasha speaking. You must be proud of what he did. I boast not in myself, but in the cross. I boast in what he did on the cross. I boast in his glory. Every time that Satan gives a challenge, he is not challenging you. We are just a piece of dust. Let's get real. God chose me to fight against a principality. That's huge when you think about that. He chose you to be able to go up against a principality. Don't get it confused. Who do you think you are? And we're going to go into it. Who does God say I am? So let's first go to this ministry's core scripture, which is Romans 8:17. And if children, then heirs, namely heirs of God and fellow heirs with Christ, if indeed we suffer with him, so may we also be glorified with him. So I always say, I'm a billionaire, H-E-I-R, heir to the throne, joint heir with Christ, meaning if I endure with his suffering, I also endure in his glorifying, meaning those promises, those blessings that he has given to me, I have access to him because I am heir to him. That's a typo that's bothering me. Anyway, therefore, I am heir to the throne and joint for Christ. Another scripture is Ephesians 2:10 says, I am God's workmanship created to produce good works, for we are his workmanship, having been created in Christ Jesus for good works that God prepared beforehand so that we may do them. So I am his great workmanship. And just think about it. If you are a parent, you know, and you, I just think about how my husband does when he looks at his sons, and it's almost like an admiration, you know, and he admires them. He's looking in admiration of, wow, this is flesh of my flesh, bone of my bones. This is a product of my seed. And what does a good father do? A good father equips and grooms his children so that they can be good citizens in the kingdom and in the world. And so just think about that. When you think about that word, you're a good father, that he's your father, he's your workmanship. He are made in his image and in his likeness. So I'm a mini God, small g, not big G, but I'm made in his image and his likeness, meaning that whatever he does, I am able to do. Why? Because he has granted me and given me dominion to be able to do those things. And so that's not by a light feat. I had a revelation Monday morning in my prayer, or in my study of God. And he just took me to Genesis 3, and he just kept showing me each scripture that said, and then God said, and then God said, and then God said, and then after God would say something, he would do something. So he would speak it, meaning he already had in his mind's eye what he wanted to be created. He would speak it, then he would make it so. And what he was saying to me is, just like I do, so do you. Just like I do, so do you. You need to speak it, and then you need to get to work. And speak it, and then get to work. And that's how you see the manifestation of God. So this is another one. We're talking about, who are you? I am a member of Christ's body and a partaker of his promises. Again, there's the heir. And this is Ephesians 3:6 and 5:30. The Gentiles are fellow heirs, fellow members of the body, and fellow partakers of the promises in Jesus Christ. So when the enemy's asking that question, who do you think you are? I'm an heir to the throne. I'm a joint heir with Christ. Who are you? You know, and because of that, I have access to the promises. So there means that all these things, I seek ye first the kingdom, and then all things are given to me. So there, I have dominion over this earth, just trample over serpents' heads, and you have no authority over me. So because of that, I am an heir to the throne. I walk as a king and a priest of God. All right. Who else am I? I have boldness and confident access to God through faith in Christ. And this is coming from like Ephesians 3:12, in whom we have boldness and confidence access to God because of Christ's faithfulness. Access. So everything that God has ordained for you to have, he's blessed, he's given you dominion. You have access up to that because of Christ's faithfulness. Because of what Christ did on the cross, it gives you access to be able to have access to those things. So who do I think I am? I am confident, boldness, and I have access to God through faith in Christ. That's who I think I am. Who are you? One, I'm no longer a slave, but I'm a child and an heir. When you really think about it, and you know, they just had this, I think it was the Queen Elizabeth's birthday, and they were doing some footage of it, and they showed the little boy, I can't remember the prince's, which prince son. Well, I know it wasn't Prince Harry. Anyway, the prince's son, it was one of the little boys, I think he's 3 or 4 years old, but they are going through this, and the royal court is taking pictures and waving to the people, and he's just up there playing, and he shushes his mom, put his hands over her mouth. But he didn't, you know, he's still heir to the throne. So he's still an heir of the royal court. He had access to all of the riches in that country. He has access to everything there is his. And so he's, you know, he doesn't know that, but just even some of his behaviors were just like, dude, chill out. But again, he's heir to all of those things, not because he did anything great, not because someone chose him. He was born into it. And you have been born into the body of Christ if you have been born again. So the scripture, Galatians 4:7, says, therefore, you are no longer a slave, but a son. And if a son, then an heir through God. So think about it. When you think about the royal court and you think about how these people are born into that family, they didn't do anything special to be able to receive the access that they have and the inheritance that they have. It's just through their bloodline. And what are we talking about? Cleansing generational bloodlines. So through that bloodline, you are a part of Abraham's seed. You are heir to the throne. So you need to know that. Another one is, I have been set free in Christ. It has Galatians 5:1 says, it was for freedom that Christ set us free. Therefore, keep standing firm and do not be subject again to a yoke of slavery. And I kept going over these because when the enemy spews those things out and he says these things to you, oftentimes we start feeling bad. We start thinking bad, having bad thoughts, forgetting. And then that those thoughts are what keeps us in bondage. Those thoughts are what keeps us from moving forward in the things of God. Those thoughts are what makes us feel like we're not worthy or that or we're not good enough. And that's being a slave to those thoughts. And so this is saying that we are no longer slaves. You have been set free. All righty. So these are just a few of the things that the Bible has a plethora of things where it tells you who you are in Christ. And these are just the name of few. But you need to know that because the enemy will use it against you when you don't know. And he knows who you are. And you need to know who you are and you need to know what the assignment is that you have, because the enemy will try to circumvent you from all of that. So one of the things is, as he is in this life, so am I, because he said so. If he said so, then I say yes. This thing, what Natasha says is, the biggest revenge you have is doing God's will in your life, for your life, because it is going to give him the biggest glory, because Jesus paid with his blood every last drop for you to come into the fullness of your calling. So it's important that you know who you are. And so, and you know the purpose in which you were called here, because one, it gives you a sense of clarity. You're able to move forward to do the things that God has called you to do. And it makes it easier so the enemy can't play those mind tricks on you when you know who you are and you know what you're here to do. Because then you know what steps you need to take to get there. And so anything that is not in alignment with those things, not in alignment with who God says you are, and not in alignment with the purpose that he has called you to accomplish while you're here, then it's easier to say no to those things. It's easier to kick those things to the side when you know who you are and you know what you're purposed for. So one of the things I want to just kind of challenge you to do is write a I am because God said I am declaration. And then declare it 3 times a day for 40 days. And I say that because you need to get this down in your spirit, because the enemy is not, he's on his job. He know what his purpose is, and he's relentless at doing it. And you need to be relentless at doing your, accomplishing your job, your purpose as well. But you can't do that if you don't know who you are. And that comes by you building faith, and faith comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. So you need to declare the things that God says you are over and over and over until it gets into your spirit, so that when the enemy says something stupid to you, you can combat that quickly. Or when a situation happens that you begin to mature, that you respond emotionally with a high emotional intelligence. because, you know, the enemy's on his job 24/7. It says he's before the throne accusing us 24/7. And so you need to know who you are, what you have, and what authority you have, and what you are called here to do. It just helps you to be able to navigate through this life more seamlessly. So I want to share my I am because God said I am declaration with you. And it's a little long, but, you know, y'all bear with me. Okay. So, and this is what I am reading 3 times a day for 40 days with you. I am a citizen of heaven for our citizenship. Oh, this is another. I'm sorry. That's not my declaration. Oh, but I do want to go over that one because that's a good one too. I am a citizen of heaven, for our citizenship is in heaven, from which also we eagerly wait for a Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ. So just know that you are a kingdom citizen. And I think about that too, when, because you hear all the people, all the economists saying we're going into a recession. And I say I didn't participate in the last recession we was in, and I'm not participating in this one because I live in a different system. I live in the kingdom system. So I'm a kingdom citizen. So I am in this world, but I am not of it. And in the kingdom, there's no lack. There's nothing but abundance. There's, you know, so I function from that realm, from spirit first. So when these things are happening, I know that all my needs will always be met because I am a child of the Most High God. I'm a tither. I'm a, you know, I'm a giver. And because of that, that creates a covenant. So I don't have to fret and worry about those things. Am I aware of them? Yes. But I don't have to be worried about it because I am a kingdom citizen and I function under kingdom law. So just think about that because it's huge. But I want to read my I am statement to you. I am the righteousness of Christ. I am heir to the throne, joint heir with Christ. Therefore, I have access to every promise and inheritance that he bestows. Because I am made in his image and likeness, I speak and I create. Whatever I say, I have. Deuteronomy 6, 10 through 11 is alive and active in my life. And because I listen and obey the word of the Lord, I am blessed and highly favored. My children are blessed. My family is blessed. My husband is blessed. And everyone I come in contact with are better because I share with them the Ruach within me. Everything I touch prospers. Because my hands and feet have been anointed by Yahweh Elohim, I speak and things change. I can move mountains with my words because I am the child of the Most High God. The earth has been waiting on my arrival. And now that I have matured, I teach the word of God and nations are blessed. Because I am healed, I am a healer. I have been delivered, therefore I am a deliverer. I am wealthy and therefore I create wealth. I trample on the head of Satan and cast out demons with my words because my words are aligned with God's words. Demons tremble at the sound of my voice because I spend time with the Father. He gives me words to say and his words do not return void. My steps are ordered by God and I am walking out my Psalms 139:16 book. I am fearfully and wonderfully made. I have an amazing God ordained life. The earth is better because I am here and I am walking in purpose. I speak love, kindness, peace, and hope. I edify and equip the body for kingdom living. And because of the covenant I have with Jehovah Jireh, my life is abundantly blessed. I cast my cares upon the Father and I walk in a state of rest because I know all things must work out for my good. It is written and it is so. Amen. So I want to just kind of empower you to write your I am because God said I am declaration and declare it 3 times a day for 40 days so that it can get into your spirit so that you can begin to walk those things out. So that when the enemy tries to come and ask you, who do you think you are? You are not confused like the person like in Black is King, where Simba is like, he don't know that he's royalty. You know, he acts like he doesn't know who he is. And, you know, it's just kind of like the prodigal son. He went through all of those things, but he had to go back home and take his rightful place. And so God wants to do that with you. If you've strayed away, he wants to always bring you in. And he wants you to remember who you are in Christ, whose you are, and what you have access to and authority to, because you've been given a purpose and he wants you to walk that purpose out. So I want to empower you to write your I am declarations. Remember to love, like, and share this with someone. I think it will abundantly bless. I know it will abundantly bless them, not because of me, but because the glory of God. And he wants us to know who we are. So write out your I am, because God said I am declarations, and begin to declare those things so that you can really hear, really begin to walk out who you are in the kingdom. So that is, that's all I have for you tonight. We are going to go into prayer and I'm going to get out of here. So Father God, we thank you for the word today. We thank you for letting us know who we are. We thank you for giving us access to our Psalms 139, 16 books. We thank you for revealing this to us, our assignment, so that we may walk in purpose. We thank you for ordering our steps so that we may do your will and your way, and the world will be better because we are here. We thank you for it. We bless you. We magnify you, glorify you, and worship you. God, you are Elohim, you are Adonai. You are all in all, and we love you. We thank you. We bless you. And we say amen, for it is so. We are who you say we are. All right, saints. So I'm going to say, thank you for tuning in to Biblically Speaking. I really would like for you all to share this with someone. I hope what was said here blesses you, and that you begin to really walk in who you are. If you have not had access to your 139:16 books, ask for it. And then begin to really walk in the authority that God has given you, because he's given it to you for a reason. And we are here to take over for the kingdom. And so you do that when you're walking in authority and in your assignment. So it's been a pleasing pleasure, darlings, to speak with you tonight. This is another episode of Biblically Speaking, where we take trending topics and give a biblical worldview. I'm your host, Tiffany Renee, your billionaire boss chick, H-E-I-R, heir to the throne, joint heir with Christ, equipping you to live this kingdom life. And until next time, you all be blessed.